I think we can comfortably call this a scepter from Steinkopf in the Northern Cape of South Africa. I call these the Namakwa quartzes. And what's interesting here, typically the Namakwa quartzes are smoky, but in this case it's an amethyst, most likely some traces of smoky here. There is contact around this section, so that's not perfect, but furthermore you've got to have crystallization going right around. This white coating is maybe feldspar busy turning, or maybe albite feldspar turning into a quartz, or silicifying, or maybe being trapped inside a quartz solution. Definitely a second generation graying on that face. Form wise, we're talking about a scepter. I think length to length, we're looking at about 4 inches, which is a pretty good size, pretty visible scepter. Milky quartz at the bottom going into the amethyst point. And this is all, if you have any doubts, these are all absolutely natural. I don't deal with synthetic stones. I actually saw some very interesting clusters of quartz offered online of late on eBay, which I think people stick them together with resin on the base, so they look so perfect. But this is absolutely natural as it occurs in nature. And of course, from Namakwa land on the Orange River, South African side, Steinkopf to be precise, quite rare, the amethyst from there, quite abundant. You get the smoky quartz. And of course, one of the things about these is these amazing forms they make. And I'd say we're comfortably talking about a scepter and a good prominent size.